Hi everyone, this is Aki with another keynote video, and this is a third one in our series of going over table charts and formulas in Keynote. And we're going to go over how to use formulas in Keynote when you have tables and so on. And we're going to go through a few examples. And if you want to know how to format your table so it looks nice, just click the video in the corner. And that video will show you how to make it look nice like such if you're pasting it from Google Sheets or Excel. So now we're just going to go over the formulas, and I want to show you a list, and I'll put the link in the notes. Basically, this is a support guide information on Keynote on Apple website, and it has a lot of functions that it supports, about 250, and it has the basic ones that you have in Google Sheets and Excel and so on. And if you click each of them, you can see like the plus icon, you can see more detail what kind of formulas are listed. And so most of the ones you will use in Keynote are the basic ones. Some of the more complicated calculation you'll probably do in Google Sheets or Excel. And anyway, Keynote is just to show like a summary of your data, so maybe some summary analysis and so you were probably going to use like the basic function, which are like average, sum, round, minimum, maximum, and so on, and just simple calculation, adding, subtracting, calculating percentages. Whenever you paste information from like Google Sheets or Excel, like it pastes as values. So I actually like to use formulas in Keynote when I have any kind of tables, because I just want to double check that while I was formatting or changing things that I didn't make a mistake, and then you're surprised that actually you're presenting something and the data is incorrect. There's a missing digit or what have you. So I'm going to start with this example. Let's calculate average, total, and sum of totals. So let me actually remove these. I'm going to select these cells and start from the beginning. So when I pasted the data here, it's a value data. And let's say I want to calculate an average of this quarterly data for car sales in 2021 for like six different car makers. So you can just click on a cell, start typing equal, and that's where the formula bar will show up. And the formula bar is very small and sometimes hard to tell what's going on. So once, if you hover over it, the bottom line, then you have this like kind of arrow icon or this hand icon. Sometimes it doesn't want to show up right away, but I'll show you in a second. Or sometimes, oh, right there, it's like a hand icon. You can drag it and expand this formula bar. You can also move this away from your place, because I don't like that I don't see what's going on underneath. So I like to actually position it a little bit lower. And now you can start typing the formula. So I would say average. And now you can see Google Keynote is showing you all the formulas that are available for you. You can select one of them, and I'm going to select this one now. It's asking you for your value, and you can actually drag ranges just as you drag in Google Sheets or Excel. I can just select these four columns and then click enter. Now, another way to see the sum, if you click this check mark, you can just click the check mark and it will show you the average, the result of your formula. And once you have this formula, you don't have to redo it. You can also copy it up. You can do select the cell, command C, and select these cells and command V. You can do it in such a way, or you can also take this and you will have this like little yellow dot or circle in the middle of your cell. You can actually drag this to copy over the formula this way. And you can double check how, if the formula is showing the correct information. If you just double click on it, it will show you what it's calculating. Now, there's two also other ways to see the formula. Like, let me actually try to move this away from here. You can click on this arrow next to the function icon, and you can say show formula as text. So you see the way it's presented right now, it's like this in these boxes, formula and then the range. I can, if I do show formula as text, it's actually presenting it more like it does usually in Excel or Google Sheets. And then you can also do convert formula to text in a cell. So that would do is actually show you the calculation like this, but it's not the calculation itself. So that's the difference. So I'm going to change this to have an actual formula here. So once I calculate the average, I see the numbers here, and I worry about, you know, changing the format, because when I copy it over, I must have, let me just see my table. Table, I didn't use the alternating row, because if I do that, I actually can make this color copy over across the row. So I'll just do this. So then even if I copy the formula, let me show you. If I copy this formula now, it will not modify from the white cell. It won't modify my column and my rows that are like the light blue, because it's alternating row color. That's the way to do it. To, you know, avoid, if you have tables with formulas, I suggest to use the alternating row color, because if you're copying it over, you will come across this issue a lot. Now let's do the sum. So sum is equal, and then I will just use sum. And you also have this option, sum if, you can do sum products, some other formulas here, but I'm just going to do sum. And okay, let me do show in function browser. Oh, you can also see right now here, it's like the form function help menu. So you can have some help on your formulas right here as well. And you can also do insert function here as well. But okay, let me do one more time. Equal sum parentheses, and I'm going to change it to as text. I just like it better. And I'm going to add these four columns, close parentheses, enter. And then again, I'm going to copy it over like so. Now I also want to enter a formula that adds up total for all the six car makers. So I'll just do at the bottom, equal sum. And then just select the range. And so this is a quick way to do some of these. And I can also maybe create a round, like I can add a round function. So it, as if in Excel, like that's why I kind of like using the show formula as text, because I can just, it's easier for me to type other formulas here. So I'm going to do round, select this, comma, and then how many digits? Maybe let me do four digits. I can also add nested function within the formula in Keynote. Let's do another example. So this one is an interesting one. Let's say you have some kind of, you know, financial presentation of stocks and pricing, and maybe, you know, you're working on this presentation and over time, like you don't want to go back and have to pull this data for these stocks. Maybe the presentation you started 2 months ago, so you don't want to keep updating it. So this is actually a good option, which is the formula that you can use in Keynote is stock. Then you put the symbol, and then it's optional value. And now let me show you. Let's go to the formulas. Oh, like here, it would tell me more information on the syntax and what kind of information I can ask for in the formula. And you can see the formula right now, it's stack, which is you have to provide a symbol. And then price, this price actually has multiple options. You can say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. There's a list of how many, 25 different things you can pull for this stock. And each of these numbers represent like either price, name, change, and etc. Okay, now you see this, you must specify a value. So this will be an error. Like whenever you see something like this, it's an error. And that means the formula is, something is wrong with the formula. So I'm going to change this. Okay, so now let's start typing our formula here. So let's say I'm going to take this. So if you want to delete the formula, just select and delete basically. You can do this. No, I don't want to do this, but I can just do right click on the cell and clear all, so I can delete the formula. Sometimes it doesn't work if I just try to, it did work this one, but sometimes it doesn't want to like delete for some reason, just goes to the formula, even though I'm The X just makes basically saying cancel changes and close. So it's not really deleting the formula. If let's say, if I do this and click check mark, then I'm deleting the formula. Okay, equals stock parentheses. And now I'm going to reference this. And now I'm going to also select which option. So name, I have to check what's name. Name, what number do I have to put for name? For name, it's one. I have to put one, close parenthesis, and enter. And now I have the name. Now, if I want to copy this over, like we were talking about, and then do, you see here, I put the names of the options that I have to select just to reference quickly so I don't have to look for it in the guide. So let's say if I have this, and now once I have this formula and I want to copy it over like so, okay, I have all kinds of errors. Why? Because actually here, if I double check this formula, I can see what is happening. It's actually referencing B3. So it's not referencing the symbol, but it's referencing the name. So I actually have to select B2 in my formula and make it an absolute reference. So I'm going to go back to my original formula, and here I'm going to say preserve row and column. I just want to preserve the row because column, actually I'm going to be later on copying this formula across. So I want to preserve row. So these are the options for absolute reference. And now if I click enter, and now if I copy it over, it is working. But now I want to change what I'm referencing. So I want to not do the name, but you see, you can actually click on here and it shows you what options do you have for this formula, price. And then I'm going to do the same thing here. I want a volume, which was, you see, let me just actually move this value. Volume was 8. Then high, 52 week high, it's 11. And 52 low, that's 12. Annual dividend, that's number 20. So I already kind of went through it, so I know. Okay, so now in here, it's not available. But I'll show you what to do in case you have an error. And earning per share, 21. And finally, PE ratio, 20. So whenever you have this and you might have an error, you can also add an if error nested formula beforehand. So I'm going to say if error, what to do? Maybe put not available. And that's what happens. And now I can actually copy this, and you have this like yellow dot in the middle. You can drag this across and it will copy for all the other tickers and symbols that you have for each of the companies. So you know, it's a quick way of referencing and using the stock formula as well as if an error formula if you have errors in your calculations. Here's another example that we have average home prices, and I want to do an average, and we already did the average calculation before. Let me see if okay, you see, this is not a formula because I pasted it over, so I can just use average formula for each of the regions, and then I can copy the formula. Oh, you see, it's very sensitive. Like when you click anything, it's very sensitive. I can just click the X not to change anything in my formula and copy the formula over. Now, percentage change. So that's another one that you might be using a lot. So let me delete this and show you how to calculate that. So let's actually make this box a little bit bigger if I can select this. Okay, so what we want to do, percentage change is basically taking the new value, subtracting the old value, and divided by old value. So I'm going to use parentheses because I want to make sure that my arithmetic is correct, saying the new value for 2022, subtract the old value, close parenthesis, and divide. Okay, it's the division, yes. When I click the slash, it does the division sign, like mathematical division sign, and then divide it by 2021, the old value, click, press, and then you have the calculator formula, and then we just copy it across. Whenever you click on a cell, you can see it shows you what is it using, which cells it's referencing. Another one, quick one here, this one is just basically using a sum of these total car sales by region across, so that's something we have ever done. Finally, this is a final example in our video that we're going to go over. It's kind of like using a table, and I have a table here, and it is using a table, but I removed all the formatting so you can't tell, but it's like a clean presentation of the calculations. If you ever want to lock it, like, you know, because whenever you're adding some other formatting, you want to make sure you lock it so you don't make some inadvertent changes to your table. But right now, because I'm going to put formulas, I want to show you how to do that. So I have basically tax calculation for 2022, and I have a single taxpayer with taxable income of 100,000. And the brackets, I'm just showing some of the brackets that are applying, because there are also more brackets for each taxpayer. But right now I'm just showing a 10%, 12, 22, 24. And it's saying, you know, the income between 0 and 10,000, it's taxed at 10%, between 10,000 and 41 at 12%, and so on. So it's like a progressive tax system that basically the tax rate increases as your income increases. And just want to show you that you're not finding your highest tax bracket. So if this person is in a 24% bracket, you're not going to take 100,000 times the 24 as you know, and the tax rate will be 24,000. You're actually going to have to calculate at each tax rate how much you pay in taxes. So we're going to do that. So amount of income at each. So what I want to do is basically say how much of income at this tax bracket would be in total. So I'm taking the maximum value, subtracting the minimum. So you're using subtraction. Now later on, I can take this yellow dot and copy over the formula. Now for the last item, I have to change the formula because now it's taking the maximum 170,000, subtracting 89, but I actually have 100,000, not 170. So I can just actually click on the here and remove this item, select the cell that I want, and click and check to enter it. And now I have, this is the income level at each of the brackets. There will be tax at each of the brackets, so at the corresponding bracket. So now I want to multiply by tax rate, so I can say equal, select. Now I can just move this maybe somewhere else a little bit because I can't tell what's happening. I like to be able to tell what's happening. Take this amount at each of the bracket rate, multiply by tax rate, and press enter or check. And now I'm going to drag this formula down. And now this is total for each of the tax bracket that I will be paying. So I'll be paying 2,622 at 24%. And then at 22%, I'm paying 10,000. And each, and at 10%, I'm paying 1,000, and so on. And each of them, I want to add them up. So I'm going to do sum, and I'm going to select the cells and enter. So right now it shows me, okay, so I'm actually going to be paying taxes 17,836 versus if you just did a plain calculation, if this was not a progressive increasing tax rates tax system. So this is like a quick way to basically show an example, and I can also select the table and some of these formatting that I've done and lock it. So even if I change anything or move anything, I'm not affecting my calculation. So you want to make sure you, when you do the calculation, lock your table so nothing can be changed by an accident. As you can see, it's very sensitive. So sometimes that can happen. So thanks so much for watching.